some awesome ministry today. Great word, amen. I come to start a spiritual war. I'm dressed in my, and what I feel like my spiritual ephod. I got my spiritual bulletproof vest on. I got my prayed up vest. You saw this vest the last time in my video, prayed up. Amen. I might even drop some of that song today. I don't know. Because I'm prayed up right now. And I'm prayed up for the kingdom. And I'm coming to start a kingdom fight. Tag everybody right now. Tag everybody right now. Invite people into this service, worship service. We're going to be explosive today. We're going to teach the truth about this people in this church religion, how they kill it, ministry, and knock it down. New converts. We're going to deal with the Kanye West mess and the drama and the idiot things that they're doing in that. I want to know that we're going to have, we're going to talk, preach the word from the scripture today on about things like Kanye West and about new converts, sinners, and church folk. That's going to be the message today. So I want you to get in your prayer mode. I'm in my prayer mode. I'm prayed up. I'm ready for war. Like, it just, I just feel like it just, it's a spiritual, it's got to be a spiritual awakening. And people coming to Christ, and we can't kill the flow of God, can't kill the ministry of God. I'm ready for war. And I want to welcome anybody else to this live service. And we want to thank God for being alive today. So you understand, when people come from the depth of hell, and y'all pray for me. I've been down for like 2 days, 3 days. I've been sick. So I've been in bed for 2 days. I was in bed all day Friday. I was in bed all day Saturday. But hallelujah, I got up early Sunday morning. Amen. Got a little resurrection in me today. Amen. So my voice may be tricky today, but I'm going to go forth in power. But we don't know the power and the depths of hell that real sinners come from, that people come from real pain, from a real loss place, and we are taking our world into a sunken place by coming against the kingdom of God. When we are supposed to be coming against the kingdom of darkness, fighting the elements of evil and high wicked places, and we are fighting each other. We are doing atrocious stuff. So we're going to get into a little worship and praise, and we have been dissing this man, Kanye West. I come to say, get your mama off of him. I'm not representing him. I'm representing the new era of people like him and new converts that's coming in behind him. We're not going to do this. We're going to put some Bible to it. We're going to give praise and worship. We're going to use some of his songs, because ain't nothing wrong with what this man is saying in his songs. I listened to it. I went to the service. We're going to get that. We're going to let every knee shall bow. Let's go. Get a little worship going on. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess. You got a problem with this song? Something wrong with your spirit. You got an issue with this man's song right here? You ain't got God. Listen to what he's saying. Let's go.
Jesus is Lord.
You man.
Jesus is Lord. Every nation bow. Every tongue confess.
You man, bow.
They all say they real till it's time when you praise it. I seen them come and go, you only the latest. But who am I to judge? I'm crooked as Vegas.
Use this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven. We call on your blessings. In the Father, we put our faith.
Tag somebody right now. Come on, let's go. Get the word. Get your Bible's out. Tag somebody right now. Yeah. Get prayed up ready. Get prayed up ready.
Put our faith.
Come on, there.
A lot of damaged souls, a lot of damaged those. And then my arrogance took a camera pose. Caught with a trunk, the very man of nose. They sing a different tune when the slammer close. From the concrete grew a rose. They give you rape talk, I give you faith talk. Blindfolded on this road, watch me faith walk. Just hold on to your brother when it's faith lost.
Kenny G, let's blow it. That's war music. That's warfare. This was the new age, the new era. Don't stop the young people from coming to God. Don't suffer them from coming to God. May not be for you. This for your grandchildren. Let them come. Glory, glory. We don't worship Kanye West. We don't worship no entertainers. We bow down to the King. Children's children. Bring the power of God to us. Yeah. Don't stop them. Don't stop them. Don't stop them. Stop. I wanna just go get about a couple of seconds of my prayer. Just a couple of seconds of this. Get your Bible. I'll turn to Matthew chapter 9. Turn to Matthew chapter 9. You're gonna go on the word now.
I gotta pray on this.
We gotta pray.
I pray for the hood on this.
Get Matthew chapter 9.
I'm in the red.
Down verse 9.
I'm at the murder max.
Joy Road.
I'm on 7 mile. 3-4 is 6 mile.
The hood.
Go.
Yo. I pray to God we pray up. I pray to God that we pray up. I pray to God that we pray up. Don't let the boy get K'd up. Don't let the house get sprayed up. Pray for the baby's son. Baby got his hate up. Lord Jesus. Good baby, get your way up.
Shoot me out here. I'll be telling
Jesus Christ to save us. Ain't no devil that can fade us.
God,
give us money, try to play us.
Play us.
I pray to God that we pray up.
Pray up.
I pray to God that we pray up.
Sweet.
I pray this boy don't do it. Lord,
don't
let this dumb boy do it.
Don't do it.
One shot and he do it. He self-checked and I do it.
Check it.
I'm a ball hard when I shoot it. Angel ain't let me walk straight through it.
Amen.
I'm in the game and I'm jaded.
Matthew chapter 9.
I'm on 7 and I'm prayed.
Matthew chapter 9. Amen. Matthew chapter 9. Let's get into our word. Amen. Tag somebody into it. Matthew chapter 9. We're talking about. We want to go right starting in verse 13. Verse 9. Matthew 9, giving that verse 9. And you find these words recorded. It says, as Jesus passed on lights and walls from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the tax office. And he said to him, follow me. So he arose and followed him. 10 says, and now it happened, as Jesus sat at the table in the house, that behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with him and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw it, they said to his disciples, why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners? 12 says, and when Jesus heard that, he said to them, those who are well have no need for a physician, but those who are sick. But go and learn what that means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. I'm going to read that again right there. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I come to call the righteous, but sinners
and to repentance. And I want to read right there, verse 11. He said, and when the Pharisees saw it, they said to his disciples, why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners? I want to preach from the subject, fight for it, wilderness attacks, part 4, friendly fire, Kanye killers. Friendly fire, Kanye killers. When I talk about Kanye killers, I'm not talking about Kanye West and just himself. I'm talking about the era of a Kanye West era. We had our day when we had the Bobby Blue Bland era, the Rhythm and Blues. We had the Smokey Robinson era, the Temptation era. Then we had eras where we had different singers, Marvin Gaye. We had different eras in life where we had people that was really in a time frame where music could define what time frame you were in, right? We had eras where it was Barry White, and so we are now fast forward into a, not Jodeci, but we are now a Kanye West era. Even in the gospel world, we had different Andre Crouches and commissions, and then you had Kirk Franklin. We are now in a Kanye West era, amen. So I talk about Kanye killers, I'm talking about people that would be grouped into a Kanye West era. Amen. The era of a Kanye West, right? Not, we don't worship no Kanye. I don't know why folks so stuck on somebody worshiping Kanye. He already came out with a Yeezy Bible that did not work. Everybody follow that mess, right? So that was in his past. But I'm talking about right now, from when we just read Matthew, friendly fire. Friendly fire. Listen, y'all, a battlefield is an unfriendly place of survival. A battlefield is an unfriendly place of survival of the fittest. It is a take no prisoners, no holds barred, bloody battleground that involves casualties. A battlefield is a, I'll say it again, it is an unfriendly place of survival of the fittest. It is a take no prisoner, no holds barred, bloody battleground that involves straight up casualties. See, amen, you will get hurt in a battlefield. Battles. And when in battle, you will endure pain and injury, amen, from your opposition, amen. This means you, listen, they mean you, amen, harm. In fact, they look forward to your downfall. Your opposition and enemy, they mean to inflict more pain and injury on you on the battlefield. They look forward to you falling down and seeing you fall out with the blood in your chest, in your forehead, amen? They put a beam on you to hit you right in kill spots, amen? They trying to take you out. Listen, they discuss your demise and strategic battle plans before the attack even comes, amen? It's a big discussion to take you out, amen? They against you, amen? They prophesy your doom and will celebrate at the point of your death. Amen. That's the battlefield. And watch this, y'all. And that's cool in the game. Because watch this. All is fair in love and war. Amen. That's fair. But what is not fair and what is not cool is when a person is trying their best to fight for their life and they get shot down on the battlefield by people of their own team. That is what's not cool, that is what's not fair, and it's called friendly fire. It is the dumbest thing I can imagine in warfare. It is the most dumbest thing I've ever seen in warfare, that you will get shot and get injured and get hurt, and that's cool. They plot and plan your demise, they prophesy and doom, they celebrate your death and your fall. That's all good from your opposing enemy, but what's crazy is when you take that kind of hit from somebody on your own team. That's the dumbest thing I ever seen in warfare. Not only are you wasting good ammunition, but you're wasting energy. Come on. You're wasting energy on somebody that's on your same team, that you're, and also you are helping the enemy by inflicting injury to people in your own army. You're helping the enemy when you inflict wounds and pain to people in your own army.
Come on, come on.
Hello? Listen. Well, Pastor Mo, some of us Army people, we're from the same country, but we're not from the same faculty. Really? We ain't from the same church, we ain't from the same denomination, really? Okay, how would it look if you saw an Air Force just dropping bombs on the Navy? Oh, because we from a different branch. You Navy, you in the water. I'm in the Air Force, I'm higher than you. So I'm just going to just drop bombs right on my own Navy. How would that look in warfare? What would you have to say to that? Huh? We from the same military, but so what? Different branches. It's still USA, right? Huh? That means don't shoot at them at all. I don't care how different they look in their uniform. I don't care if they salute different. I don't care if they walk and march different. I don't care if they bootstrap up different. I don't care if they look and act and they do salute to the flag different. I don't care if they spin around and wear a different kind of gun. They are the same military, different branch. That means you cannot shoot at them at all. Amen. I don't care. And if they watch this, even if they are wounded in battle, you're supposed to go and get them and leave no soldier behind. Correct? All right. Listen. That's just the natural army, right? That somebody please tell me why in the world does God's army not understand this? You won't catch the military doing that. Court martial, prisoners of war, death. It wouldn't happen. That's the world's army. So why in the world did God, the spiritual army, don't understand this? You cannot do that. Amen? Now, the natural army is supposed to be fighting this war, but why do the Church of God, super saints, think it's their job to judge harshly? To judge harshly, come on, and shoot down other soldiers just because they knew fresh from out of boot camp. If they knew out of boot camp and they fresh and they novice and they not good with their weaponry, okay, I'm going to judge them. I'm going to shoot them down harshly and judge them harshly. That's my job because they knew. That is not your job. Listen here. They may be fighting from a different format, but then guess what? Because you're a seasoned soldier, you're supposed to go and assist them.
Yeah, that's right.
Huh? The Bible says, the person overtook in the fold of Galatians, those who are spiritual are supposed to restore them in the spirit of meekness.
Yeah.
Those who are mature, spiritual means mature, mm-hmm. Right? So you're a seasoned soldier, they are young boot camp out of training, you're supposed to go and assist them.
Yeah.
Not shoot them down and judge them harshly and go and embarrass them. And dog them and prophesy their demise.
That's right.
Amen. I think David was a little goofy in Saul's armory. Hmm. He was a newbie. He was walking looking a little goofy. He couldn't even walk in Saul. So I can't walk in this. Hmm. He's a little goofy in Saul's big grown traditional army.
Come on.
Huh? Armor. Couldn't wear it. Traditional armor, all this best they have. He couldn't decide, I can't move in this. Get this off me. Give me my little slingshot, my little sheep stuff. And he went and killed a giant in what he knew, his new era, new lightweight armor, and killed Goliath with his own weaponry. Let the young people do how God's got them doing. Amen?
Amen.
Listen. I don't understand how we can be so unsupportive. Older siblings hate. His older siblings was hating on him. What did his older siblings say? Oh, who is he? He ain't gonna go fight no giant. It's always the older ones, the older saints, the older siblings, the older church. Huh? Who is he? Now watch this. They didn't get up and move a muscle to go fight. But the young one who was ready to go and go put his life on the line, they had something to say about him. Listen, I wonder how many of those churches, if they had the opportunity that Kanye has to make millions off the record label, would they would have shut their label down like the way he did. And he told us this. He told his record label, told us all his people that anybody working on my album, you must abstain from having any premarital sex or you cannot work on my album. I don't see gospel artists doing that. Hello? Hello? I have a church? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, listen. All right, so he's fighting his own way. But the older brother's always shooting down the young soldier, but he was on a real battlefield.
Come on.
See, and it kills me. See this here. Don't come talk tough. Don't be tough tone. Church come be a tough tone like you a real demon killer. Watch this, but all you do is just, listen, go to church. All I see you do, go to church, and then get on social media and pick a fight with some new believer because you can quote my Bible to them. You tough tongue. And all you do is go to church, and then hop on social media and pick a fight with some young believer who don't know their Bible that well. That's really fire, dog. Don't be tough tongue there. See, that's not anointed. That is not your assignment. It's not. You remind me of the little of the coward. The coward that would get picked on by the big bully, and they would ignore the bully. The bully tried to call him out. They ignore him, then they want to get to the little pipsqueak and say, what you say?
Right.
No, don't go to the little pipsqueak, to the new convert, and ignore the big bully. You a coward. You're not anointed, you're a coward.
Right.
Amen? I can tell you, I know for a fact that you're a coward because see, I see you ignoring. Watch this. I see it because I don't see no super saint Steven Seagals, hard to kill, Rambo saints in these trenches. That's how I know you're a coward. You talk good in church. You talk tone in church. You talk tone on Instagram. You talk tone on Facebook to new converts. Right? But I don't see you, Steven Seagal, Rambo, first blood killers. I don't see you in these trenches. I don't see you in these streets, come on, where them choppers are spraying and they murdering little kids. I don't see you out there how I know I'm out there. Right? I don't see you standing against, watch this, a fake state troopers when they shot down little Damon Grimes. I see Oliver Brett out there. Huh? I see David Bullock out there. I don't see these big bishops out there. Y'all cowards. They're talking. They're cowards, right? I don't see you standing up, watch this, standing with the chief of police. I didn't see you stand with Chief Craig when he called out those racist officers who made the black mother walk at 24-degree weather last year and said, bye, Felicia. I made her do the walk of shame. When he called them out, did a full investigation, called the whole precinct out and fired them all. And they attacked Chief Craig. I didn't see you stand up there with me and Nugget Sue and stand up there and go stand with Chief Craig and fight when he did what was right. I didn't see you out there when they did racism against our people. Our young black mother put her in danger and below weather. These same officers who had a record of doing racist stuff, you weren't out there protesting with that. Hello? Hello? I was there. I didn't see you there. I got Mo. I didn't see you out there. I don't see you out on Sunday with Malik Shabazz. Come on. And with Crime Stoppers looking for missing young girls on Sunday. Malik Shabazz out there every Sunday. I don't see you out there on Sunday. No, what I see you is having church, preaching, collecting, and then going home. We don't see you again the next Wednesday until it's time to talk again. I see Malik Shabazz out there on Sunday at 6 o'clock through the city with papers saying that a young girl has been kidnapped, she's been missing. A young man has been killed. His mother's right here with me, she's crying. She wants some justice for her son. I don't see you out there fighting that kind of fight.
Amen.
Oh, but you tough tone on Instagram. Come on, I got Mo. I don't see you with Minister Fuqua Bay and Detroit 300 when they put the white hazmat suits on and went in them begging homes looking for dead bodies and the woman with that serial killer was killing them ladies out there. I didn't see you out there because I was there. I'm one of the only pastors out there. How I know. Amen. I didn't see you out there. I didn't get no phone call when they killed Francesca Marks and her seven children were sleeping on the kitchen pantry floor and we had to raise the money to put her seven kids in a proper bed in the house and get the money. I didn't get no phone call from Ann Bishop.
That's right.
From Ann, big religious entity. Not one called me and said, Pastor, I seen you on the news. I heard you on social media raising up funds for these seven kids that mother was murdered, unfortunately, in Rose Park. I didn't see that. I want to give something to that cause. We seek 5,000. I collect $2 from everybody in here. We got 10,000 to give those kids. $2. Oh, no, I don't see you with no stretches. Right? Should I go on? I didn't think you raised money up like those kids like me and Pastor Barry did, Church of Messiah. Yeah, we helped them. Huh? Right? I didn't see you. Some other pastors sold it to it to me. Amen. To them. Not one or two. Wasn't many. My pastor was one of them. That's about it. A couple of us did. I don't listen, I called several. Trust me. Called several. Amen. I don't see you front line at an at these abortion murderers and infant killers. I don't see you open up a pregnancy center helping out young lost girls bring God's children to term like my pastor Claude and they do at Oasis of Hope. I don't see you doing that. He put a center right next door to a Planned Parenthood clinic. That's a real option. That's a real war. They put a center right next to a Planned Parenthood abortion clinic. Say, here's the option. You want to go over there? We ain't got to go over there no more. Come over here, and we'll help you bring that child to term. We get you the prenatal care you need, the help you need, diapers, milk, pampers, a housing, whatever you need. Come over here. Let God's child come to life. That's a real war.
Amen.
Salute, Pastor May, and Oasis of Hope. That's a real fight.
Amen.
I don't see you out there sowing into his ministry. Come on, can I talk?
Come on.
Can I talk?
Come on.
Yes, sir.
I can name a whole lot more. But I don't see these Rambo saints when Muffer had a fight riot over there 2 weeks ago and the principal called my phone at 3 a.m. He was up concerned. He couldn't sleep. Concerned with those students and the safety of those teachers. He's like, man, what I'm going to do is I can't control the fight. Security can't control the fight. I don't know what to do. He up 3 a.m. He texts Pastor Mo, can you please bring the men to come over here? Why did he call me? Because he know I care. He know I'm the street sweeper. He know I would care, and he knew I would show up.
Amen.
But here's the sign of diaper. He said, bring the men. Oh, I bring the soldiers. Here's the sign of diaper. I called everybody. I text, inbox all the pastors, leaders, Christian men, and but 2 Christian men showed up. Oliver Grant, who fought the Mon Grimes case, and the other case with the boy, the man shot over there in Grosse Pointe with the dog situation with his name. He's always out here fighting with me, and Wood from the D-Spot, who went from Southern Trees to Southern Tees. D-Spot, biggest man, he showed up. Only 2 Christians showed up. Know who else showed up? The Melanic brother showed up deep. And the Moorish Islam brothers showed up with me deep. That's a shame before God.
Amen.
I had to go in there and fight with the Islam and the Melanics. And our Christian brothers were nowhere to be seen.
Amen.
Huh? I called all of them. They were nowhere to be seen. With them kids over there in the riot. And the principal was scared. Kids are scared. And they fight. And they got no help. They was nowhere to be seen. Huh? But watch this. But soon Kanye come out. And he claimed the name of Jesus. Here come Tough Tone. Here come a bunch of Tough Tone. Here come God's army now. Oh, here come they ready to fight for the Lord. They're ready to call right wrong, call wrong right. Huh? They're ready to get things straight. Huh? Ready to shoot to kill. Ready for war. They're ready for a war against a man who has his hands up and surrendered to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They're ready to go to war against a man who said, I was working for the devil, but now I say Jesus is Lord of my life. His hands is up and surrender. And you want to go to war against him?
Jesus.
But yet in these trenches, the very people that you pastor, you don't care about. What is happening in their lives. Wait, let me check something out, because I think the issue may not be Kanye West. I think the issue, Jerry, may not be Kanye West. I think one of the issues is they coveting Jesus. It's coveting. It ain't Kanye, it covetous. Listen, here's two other issues. Here's the issue. The first silly issue is they mad because, watch this. Watch how silly this is. I heard him say it. I called him. Social media. Saying it. They mad because they singing their songs better than them. They is mad. Oh, yeah. They said, yeah, these are over there. It's a copycat off the church. They mad. Watch this. Because his choir is bigger than theirs in the first 6 months. Huh? They big mad because that choir is huge and it's getting bigger. And it's sounding celestial. And they sing it, their song. How dare he sing, how excellent. Copying off the church. Like how excellent belongs to them. How excellent is thy name? Belongs to you?
My God.
Huh? They didn't want him, wasn't it? They didn't want him singing them songs. Watch this. And they wouldn't, and they wasn't even singing them songs no more. So he brought them back up. They weren't even singing that song no more. Huh?
My God.
And here's the other one. They mad because he's doing it for free. Oh, wait a minute now, Kanye. Oh, Kanye, you messed around and gonna try to have a free concert. Kanye is singing how excellent for free. We can't collect no offers no more. Oh, Kanye, you're doing a little too much now. Now, you better go sing that Jesus walk now, Kanye. Walk it off. Don't come singing on how excellent for free now. Have no free concert now, because if that's the thing you're going to do, you're going to be having a free holy convocation like they have right now in St. Louis. I can't charge you no registration fee no more. Oh, he's coming out to our church. Go get him, y'all. He coming out to our church. See, it reminds me in the Bible when Jesus was healing the people and had long lines, giving them free bread and free healings. They said they picked up stones to kill him in the temple. He messing up our money. The money is changing the Sanhedrin had a meeting about Jesus. Had a come to Jesus meeting. This man out here healing people for free. And he out here preaching for free. He out here got a crowd and feeding them for free. We can't collect no money like this. Go stop him. It's the same thing in the Bible. That's what they mad about. I promise you. He embarrassing them. Oh, Lord. Oh, listen, it's terrible, y'all. We in the last days, I promise you. They don't want this man. They got copyrights on how excellent. They think that Jesus belongs solely to the church, like it's a church fraternity or something. Well, he said that the world might be saved. I don't understand your thinking. And the rabbit hole gets deeper if I start getting into denominational beefs, because the people will turn their Jesus gun on each other.
That's right.
Start saying, each one of you, you ain't saved because you ain't baptized in his name, right?
Right.
You ain't baptized in his name. You ain't baptized in his name. Paul said, well, I ain't baptized none of y'all. Paul said, I'm so glad I haven't baptized any of y'all. Y'all horrible. Paul called them out. They start turning their Jesus gun on each other. Freely fired. Hello? Listen. I think Jesus has come for the church. They think Jesus come for the church. He ain't coming for the sinners. They think he came for the church. Listen, once you come, listen, his plan is to stuff the whole world in the church. a new creation. It's not some fraternity, not some frat, not some solicit group that you got solely to yourself.
That's right.
It's for the least of them.
The least of them.
Amen? Mm-hmm. Amen? How I know, because, watch this, I didn't see this same energy, watch this, to go and get at Kanye West, watch this, when he was lost. I didn't see the same energy to go get at Kanye West when he was lost.
That's right.
Huh? Hello? I didn't see the same energy to go get him and reconcile him back to Christ. They say, oh, that wasn't my assignment. But I think I read somewhere, turn to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians. I think I read somewhere in this Bible, 2 Corinthians 5:14. Let me read this right here. 2 Corinthians 5:14. I think they said, well, that ain't my assignment to reconcile Kanye. That ain't my job to get Kanye. My job is to judge him. I'm the church. Well, let's read this. I'm going to get Bible on this. For the love of Christ compels us, because we judge thus, that if one died for all, then all die. And he died for all, that those who live shall live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and rose again. He's 16, y'all. Hello, church. Therefore, from now on, we regard no one according to their flesh. We don't judge them according to their flesh no more. We don't, it ain't nothing with me. Look, we don't look at them on their flesh. Once he died for all. And we all are new. We all have a new flesh, a fresh chance at this new life now. We don't judge each other by the flesh when they come into Christ now. Amen? Let's go. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet we know him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now all things are of God. Let's go. Here you go, y'all. Here's the ministry go. Who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. It is our ministry to reconcile. Once Christ has reconciled himself to us through the Holy Spirit, the Spirit gets in us, it's our job to use our Holy Spirit to reconcile others as our ministry.
Amen.
Did y'all just read that? Can I go on further? 19 says, that is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. Who? The world to himself. Not imputing, what? Not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed us to the word, what? A reconciliation. Here you go, church. Here's your assignment, church. Here's your assignment, church. Traditional haters, here it is. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. As through God, we're pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he has made him who knew no sin to be sin, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. It is your duty. It is your job. It is your assignment. Once that one has died for all, and all has died in him, and we are now not known by the flesh, we are now new creatures. Old things have passed away. We don't judge them by that. We don't look at them by that. We are now been saved and been glorified and have been reconciled to Christ by his grace and his mercy and his forever loving kindness and his blood stained sacrifice on the cross of Calvary. We now have the Holy Spirit came down and fall fresh on us and given us the ministry of grace. And we now have a ministry of reconciliation, and it's to go out and reconcile others and bring them to the full body of Christ in love. Same way you were brought in.
Amen.
Amen. I don't care if you had some old church beating you like the old slaves, old grandparents, great grandparents beat their kids because they got beat by slaves and they didn't understand what child abuse was. Mm-hmm. Old folk would beat their kids and child abuse them Because the slaves would beat them with whips and naked, and they tell their kids get naked, tied to a chair, and beat them with fishing cords like the slaves did. Their masters did them. And that was a whole thinking of slavery was put into their children. And at some point, we got out of that mess. And we talk to our kids now. We train them. We chastise them when we have to. But love should come first. And matter of fact, if you ever chastise your child and don't tell them what they did wrong, that is not love. That's just child abuse. For how they gonna know what they did wrong?
Amen.
Amen. It's the teaching moment. Amen. Here we go. That's right there. So first of all, they didn't go after Kanye West. They didn't go to reconcile him when he was in darkness, working for the devil. I didn't see no protest on Kanye album from the church. I didn't see no protest. I didn't see Paul's no protest when he made Beautiful Darkness. Had a whole album called Beautiful Darkness, worshiping himself, worshiping the devil. I didn't see no protest on that. Hello? And now, when did the Pharisees have a big problem with Kanye? When he dropped, Jesus is King. Now it's a big old protest against it. It's a big old movement. But on Beautiful Darkness, I didn't see no protest to reconcile him and go and get him straight. But now when he said, Jesus is King, all we got a protest. They coming to Jesus. They coming to Jesus. That's sin. That's sin. Watch this. Look at our text. Look at our text. Back to Matthew. Look at these Pharisees. Look at Matthew 9. Matthew 9. It says, I want to see just how this thing came to pass. Because you have to understand that Jesus is sent for the world. At least to them. Look at Matthew 9. It says, Jesus passed from there and he saw a man, watch this, named Matthew. Matthew. My bad. He saw a man named Kanye. Matthew. Right? And the man, he's sitting in the tax office. Watch this, y'all. Watch this story I play out. And he's sitting in the tax office and he says to him, follow me. Watch this story. You're going to see this thing real crystal clear. God showed me this. He said, what time is it? He said, follow me. He turned this down. I hate this song. I swear I do. Thank you, Lord. I'm way behind time. He says, follow me. So he rose and followed him. Tax collector sitting there taking taxes. Jesus walked up to him and said, follow me. He follows him. Right? Now get the story. He followed him, right? What 10 say? Now it happened. This is where the trouble started, right here. Now it happened. Huh? Jesus sat at the table. Watch this. Well, look what happened, y'all. It said, now it happened. This is where the drama came in at right here. Jesus sat at the table in the house. Behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with him and his disciples. Oh, boy. Matthew's sitting there, Kanye's sitting there, doing his business. Get up, follow Jesus. But soon, Jesus come to his house. And then sat in Matthew's house, the tax collector's house, and said, when he came in his house and brought Jesus in, many people, a crowd came of sinners and tax collectors. What did it say? I read again. Now it happened as Jesus sat at the table in his house, and behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with him. Matthew brought a crowd with him.
Amen.
Kanye brought a crowd. When he came and brought Jesus, he brought a big crowd. Now what happened? See, now this is where the drum started. Now what happened? See, watch this. It says, and when the Pharisees saw this, know what the Pharisees was, right? I know what the Pharisees was. Pharisees were the most religious, super religious, temple church worshipers, Jews, it was back then. You had the Pharisees and Sadducees. Sadducees didn't believe in the resurrection. Pharisees believed that Pharisees were supposed to be like more cool than them, but Pharisees were very religious. Believe in the law. Believe in the law. Most strict. It was so called by the law. It was wash their hands and do the wrong rituals. All this rituals and all this law stuff. But God said, your heart was far from me. These were religious. These are the same people that kind of tripped Jesus up and back him the lady was caught in adultery. These Pharisees, pharisaical minds, these are very religious people who had no heart and compassion for people. Wanted to look on themselves all the time. He said, doing the long prayers. Everybody said, don't. He said, don't give nobody no art, no gift, and tell nobody because they were going to give gifts to make themselves look big. Give offers and put a lot of coins to look real big. Everything they did, they tried to make themselves look like it was all of them. These were Pharisees. And they was judgmental against everything. Right? Remember Paul said, touching the law, a Pharisee? Right? So he said, the Pharisees, when they saw this, who saw? Pharisees. And they said to the disciples, why do your, look what they said. Read it now. It said, the Pharisees saw this, what they say. They said to his disciples, why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners? Oh, let's go into that. Let's go into that. Because watch this. Matthew is unsaved, but he's calling, and instantly hundreds of people came. Hunters came to him, right? This tax collector, he had a, watch this, he had a booth on the side of the road where he would, people would come past. They had a toll booth. He would come past, the people hanging back to him. He was charging them, he was taxing them. Come past that booth, you gotta pay him. They would put pressure on your family. Take their money. They can stand this tax collector. He bought their money. He worldly. He worked for the enemy, he worked for Herod. Right? And they said, why in the world is Jesus in the eating with the man who taught us to get that money for the enemy? Why he eat with them and them sinners? Watch this, y'all. They were considered to be traitors. They despised the tax collectors. But here's my notice, y'all. They didn't say nothing to the tax collector while he was on the side of that road, that booth. Which means while he was in the streets, Ashley, they ain't said nothing to him. Huh? They ain't said nothing to Matthew on the side of that toll booth in the streets. He was on the side of the road with a toll booth in the streets. He was on the side of the road and a toll booth charging taxes in the streets. They didn't go to those trenches and say nothing to Matthew. Did they? Hello? Okay. Okay. Listen. And watch this. But he worked with the enemy. They said nothing to say. I didn't see no protest on his toll booth. I didn't see nothing on that talking. They was talking under their breath about Matthew. Right? Then 10, now it happened. He comes to the house and sit down with the sinners and here come the crowd. Here's what they say. Now was the time to open up my mouth. When Matthew, when he come to Jesus and sit in the house in the church setting, now it's time for church people to come out and go out at night. When Kanye West out there making beautiful darkness, we don't have nothing to say about that in the streets. But now when he comes to Jesus, coming to church and bringing in many sinners and collectors, now's the time for the church to rise up and warn against Kanye. Huh? They paid the money and they were scared to call that devil out on the first trip. Right, cowards on the side of that road. They had nothing to say to Matthew in the streets, right? Not even to go to war on the street on Matthew. Oh, my bad, yeah, Kanye, Matthew, my bad. Watch this, he comes to Jesus' house, watch this, and not even to say something. Listen, but who did they say something to? Did the Pharisees go to Matthew, say anything to Matthew? No. They ain't going to try to reconcile Matthew, even though they had a ministry to reconcile him. No. Okay. Did they go to Jesus and say, Jesus, we want to talk to you about this and see if this is wrong? We don't know if Matthew should be, you should be dealing with Matthew like this. Did they go to Jesus? No. What did the Bible say they did? Who they went to? They went to his disciples. which means they went to the crowd, which means they went to the all listeners, which means they went to social media, which means they went straight to the gram. Well, I'm like Sodom, baby. I got beef with the devil. I'm going to shoot this Bible to a gem in my hand. They went to the gram with it. They went right to disciples and say, hey, disciples, why your master eat with them sinners and publicans? They ain't go to Matthew. They ain't go to the sinners. They ain't go to Jesus. They went to the disciples. They went to Instagram and Facebook. Facebook gangsters. Twitter fingers. Huh? Talking tough on social media. Tough tones on keyboard gangsters. Right? Look what it said. They went to the disciples. Why does your teacher eat with these devils and these sinners? Do you think they would have went to Jesus? Jesus, make them stop. Make them stop, you know, doing this in your name. Because at least with Jesus, no, Jesus, he ain't right. But they tried it before in the Bible before. Oh, you want to remember? You want to see Matthew? Go to Mark 9. Mark 9, 37. They tried it before. It says, whosoever receives one of these little ones in my name receives me. Whosoever receives me receives not me, but he who sent me. 38 says, now a child answered him, saying, teacher, we saw someone who does not follow us casting out demons in your name, and we forbade him because he does not follow us. He ain't in our tradition. He ain't from our branch. He ain't army. He's using your name, killing demons, but he ain't with us. We saw him, and we rebuked him. We forbade him. Don't do it no more. Right? But 39 say, but Jesus said, he's going to read that as Jesus talking, do not forbid him. For no one who works a miracle in my name can soon afterwards speak evil of me. For he who is not against us is on our side. For whoever gives you a cup of water to drink in my name because you belong to Christ, assuredly I say to you, he will by no means lose his reward. Watch this. But watch this, church. Watch your mouth now. But whoever causes one of these little ones mean new converts, new believers, young people,
amen,
young saints, just join. Whoever caused one of these little ones, to stumble, it would be better for him if he put a millstone around his neck and he were hung around his neck and was thrown into the sea. If your He said, now, this man is not from your neighborhood. He's not from your denomination, right? He ain't from your tradition. He ain't from your era. He worships different. He cast out big, rich demons. He going to tell the millionaires, follow God. Got his sister-in-law is a billionaire. Follow God. Got Kim Kardashian worshiping God. They got millions of people following behind them. Follow God. It ain't none of you people you can never reach. People you can never reach. He a babe. He's too young, Pastor Mo. He's going to find a pastor to be taught. Who are you? Paul got saved, got knocked down, got right up and started preaching. Pastor Mo got knocked down, got shot seven times, got right up and started preaching. Who are you? We have a special, some of us are special ops. Everybody ain't called for this. Right? So watch this. So they was mad because this man, they said, he over there preaching in your name. He ain't with us. He ain't from our traditional background. He don't do the songs the right way. He ain't came and kissed the Christian ring. He ain't came and went to all the greats and kissed their butt and got a song through Rass Allen on them. He ain't did all that yet and worked his way up. We forbid him not. Let's call fire down and stop him. We forbid him. Jesus said, leave him alone. He working in my name. He ain't for us. He with us. Leave him alone. He has an assignment, and he's doing it in my name. He will not lose his reward. Worry about your reward. Matter of fact, he said, matter of fact, anybody I catch putting their mouth on him and stopping these young people from coming to Christ, and a young one, it's better to put a milestone, a big old heavy thing on your neck and hop in the sea and kill yourself. than a fool robbed a fist. Watch your mouth. Hello? Back to my text. I gotta fix this out. Why do we eat with those taxes and consumers? Why does this guy drop number one album? How does Kanye come number one album and he just got saved? Shouldn't he be better on gospel records? He got 26 million sold. Not even thinking, idiot. 26 million records sold could equate to at least half 13 million confessions to Christ. Why are you mad? 26 million souls. Jesus is King. His name is Abel. Preacher Jesus. That could be at least half 13 million souls to Christ. Well, enough of all this talking. Me talking and everybody else talking. Let's go back and look and see what Jesus said about this. We're going to get up out of here. Let's see what Jesus said, because verse 12, why you eat with the taxes and the sinners? Talking to the disciples. He was talking to the disciples, but Jesus overheard them. I was going to say, what they say? He said, oh, wait. Jesus over there doing something else, right? They come at the disciples, but Jesus, he can hear everything. He heard everything. He said, well, hold on. What they say? And walked up like, they said, what? He said, wait a minute, I'll handle this. 12 say, look, read 11. They was not talking to Jesus, was they? I'm reading again. And when the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, they wasn't talking to Jesus, was they? No. Okay. Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners? But Jesus heard it. He overheard it. And he responded to them, I'll handle this. Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick, go and find it what and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice, for I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Okay. I think Jesus just told somebody off. Translation, I'm about to go. I need 2 more minutes and I'm out of here. Translation. What he said from 3 to 12. Translation. He says, I'm a doctor. I'm a spiritual doctor with real healing, with real power to heal. They actually call me the healer. Right? And people only come to a doctor once they recognize they're sick.
That's right.
Huh? And beyond their own ability to deal with it. Right? No, since y'all think y'all so intelligent, he said, go learn what this means. What he means was, since y'all think y'all so intelligent and know the law so good, and go do your research, huh? And find out what this old scripture here means. He says, what he says? He says, now go learn what this means. What are you talking about? The next thing he dropped was a quote. He drops a quote from Hosea 6 and 6. He says, go learn what this means. Then he says, see the quotations there. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. That is a quote from Hosea 6 and 6. He dropped them an Old Testament. He says, did y'all so out cold with the law of Moses in the old book? He says, go learn with this. Go research this. Go research Hosea. Y'all know who Hosea was, right? Hosea was a man that God told her to marry Gomer. Gomer was a whore, a harlot, huh? A prostitute. Gomer was a woman who said he slept with men all night, came home, spent like sex. And he told Hosea to marry her. He said, and do not be faithful to her. He said, I want you to feel what it feel like, a tenth of what it feel like to be married to a woman who would never be faithful to you, who would never be your own. And you will have an inkling of what it's like for me to be married to this backslid, adulterous world.
My God.
So he drops Hosea on 6 and 6. And it says, I desire mercy, not sacrifice. Which mercy meant, watch this. Mercy meant loyalty, or it meant true devotion. It meant loyalty or true devotion. And God says, I've already judged the sacrifices without mercy from the law, and it was worthless. He said, go read Hosea 6. I desire what? Desire mercy and not sacrifice. He says, I've already judged them with the law on these sacrifices, Levitical laws. And the people couldn't keep the law. They died in their sins. I had destroyed the whole world. He said, that was worthless. It didn't work. So now my mercy, my grace, my Jesus, my Savior comes in. Come on. He said, I desire true devotion to Jesus. All you got to do is be true to me. That's it. Obedient to me. That's it. Right? And you would grow from there. Right? They was too ignorant to realize, watch this, they were standing there on the mercy. But they pious, scrupulous, pretentious perception of righteousness had them lost in their mind, thinking that, no, we want the sacrifice. We here on our merit. We here on our sacrifice. They pious, scrupulous mentality, perceived perception of their own self-righteousness had them thinking that we here on our sacrifices, on our merit. And we calling for that. Lord, I'm going to close now. I'm done. Watch this. He said, even if I found, look what the end say. He says, for I did not come to call righteous, but sinners to repentance. He said, even if I found you righteous, come on, without mercy, I didn't come for you. Even if I found you, he said, I didn't come for the righteous. I didn't call the righteous, right? I called sinners to repentance. Even if I followed you righteous without my mercy, which is impossible, but if I did do that, he said, I didn't come for you. That means you don't need a physician. See, you don't need my medicine. Amen? See, I'm sick. I need medicine when I leave here. He's sniffing. I'm sick. I need medicine. He said, but you're so healthy. You're so strong. You're so self-righteous. You don't need my medicine. You don't need me. So I ain't talking about you. He said, your grace, your own self is sufficient. You good. He said, I come to call sinners, the world, the thugs, the blind, the rich that worship their money. I got a love potion that's going to make them repent and praise my name. See, I need the sick people. I'm a real doctor. I need real people that's sick. See, I need somebody to come take the seat. See, and I would call, so I go sit down, take my seat. I would call Kanye West. If I'm not lying, tell me I'm lying. Didn't that man have a nervous breakdown, dye his hair blonde, and went to a mental institution? Was he not declared sick? Come on. Did he not declare he was on medication? Did he not declare he was unhealthy? Did that man not lose his whole mind? Did that man not go to the war, come out of here, and get preached to Jesus, and came out of here different, came out of here walking different, talking different, claiming the Lord when he was on his own Yeezy, on his own merit? Come on. His self-righteous, beautiful darkness, God couldn't do nothing with him. But when he got sick and lost his mind, he said, I come not to call the righteous, but I come to call sinners and also sick to repentance. It was then he lifted up his head, come on, and every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. Come on. It's the Sunday. It's the last day. Come on. Worship. Y'all got church pause on Sunday. I like what God is doing. Come on. It was then God came in and lifted him up out of his sick ward. Come on. It's then God is coming out of a whole new generation. It's then God is calling spiritual warfare. It's time for a new age. All y'all old traditional saints, set out somewhere and let God be God. Come on. Let the new generation come in. Y'all had y'all time. And y'all blew it. Y'all played and knocked them down and wouldn't get nobody up. Y'all collected offers and wouldn't help the poor. Y'all said y'all didn't feed nobody. Y'all didn't fight for no justice. It's time for free worship. It's time for true devotion. So anybody want to see how excellent is thy name? You're welcome to sing as loud as you want to. It's closed on Sunday. Come on, open up the church on Monday. It's time to bring warfare to the devil and stop fighting each other. I do not want friendly fire. power. You are my Savior. You are my Master. You are my Lord. I worship you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, fall fresh on me. Clean me in your time. Clean me, holy fire. Burn my sin away. I give my life, my soul to you. Say this prayer with me, that Jesus is Lord. The Bible says you are saved. Be baptized and repent and work out your salvation. In Jesus' name.
Sunday.
Amen.
You my
Chick-fil-A.
Close
thank
on Sunday.
Lord. Grace.
You my Chick-fil-A.
Mercy.
Hold the
selfie.
Put the gram away.
Bless your people, Lord.
Get your family.
And our families come together.
Bow hands and pray.
Let the era of Kanye West, our new converts come to Christ.
Always keep them safe.
Pray for that
young
man. Pray for that era of young believers.
Don't let them
indoctrinate. We cast off any demonic activity. We don't pray. We don't praise this political
beliefs.
We don't praise this Trumpism. We don't praise this music. We worship the Christ and his right to Christ. And anybody else behind him, right to Christ.
Through temptation,
we rebuke anybody going against
sure
him.
Wide
and the church is time for us to come together
Jesus,
and put that mess aside.
And
you are my body, my bone,
no
rest of my flesh.
You
cannot do it
no
separate. We are one body, one faith, one baptism.
Stand up for my home.
Let's go. I will fight this fight.
Even if I take this walk alone.
I know what's right. I know what scripture says.
Bow to the king upon the throne.
Let's bow down to the king.
Life is his.
If Kanye changed that message, we're going to pray for him. If he changed that message, we're going to pray for him. That's it. But those who got saved, it won't change their salvation. Hallelujah. It won't change their salvation. It won't change their belief in Jesus.